Hello, everybody. Recording live from somewhere. Making more original 3D artwork. Experimenting with Gravity Sketch. Learning things. Sharing. And spreading love. Wherever you happen to be, however you happen to view this. You're watching The Dubious Life. Some music. Let's get our workspace set up. Got our preferences over here. Some good mirroring. We're gonna take our strokes, various tool panels there, and last but not least, our layers menu. Critical to working inside Gravity Sketch. Make some adjustments to my really old headset. Get as comfy as I can get. With some low resolution VR. And then let's pull up some of our reference images. So I have a bunch of drawings that I've made over the last 30 years or so, but we're only gonna look at the ones from the last 10, I'd say. So let's look at our reference window and see if there's anything in here that we feel like working on. This Ant Factory was done on a previous stream. And I've been digging on this concept of like art as a home for a while, but I don't have enough time to do that, give that justice. Just scrolling through some items from Volume 1. One did kind of reach out and grab my attention. Going to be focus, but let's start with this. Let's see if we can just grab this guy. Boom. Drawing of a hand drawing. Amazing. And then we have a couple of those. That's a recurring theme for me. It's one of my warm-up sketches. Is this sort of abstract hand drawing. And here it is actually explaining it. Abstraction of energy in the hand when sketching. So, a bunch of hidden vectors there. Now, this is a scan from a sketchbook. This was done with just regular pen and ink, no undo button, which is generally how I like to roll. But it's really hard to sculpt in 3D in VR with traditional materials. So this is going to be our reference. So we've got a viewer, welcome to the stream, wherever you are, hope you're well, it's crazy times. We got our reference sketch up, we got our tools ready, and we have our workspace. Now, I would love to see the developers, the kind folks over at Gravity Sketch, put this together and make this like a saveable workspace. I'd love to boot in and just see this. But, you know, I'm pretty happy with what we've got here. So we've got this mirror set up, right? And you can kind of see whatever I draw, it's going to get mirrored. It's this nice little tramp stampy thing. But that's not what I want. So if we're going to do this, you look at this drawing here. Always have a pen stroke. And then it's going to be interesting to see if we can weave the same kind of line pattern into a 3D representation. So you can see that. It's kind of this. Yep. So the front finger is a pointer finger up to the second knuckle. Final knuckle there. And then the joint here. All right. Yeah, that looks pretty good. I'm going to move this out of the way because I suspect that to you watching the stream, it's a lot better when you can see the rendering because you're looking at it in 2D without without the clutter. That's what you can do there. And there's also a way to show a separate camera. And we'll look into that if there's demand for such. Right. So let's group this. And it's kind of pointing down, right? It's drawn on a page there. And then what you don't see in the, what's interesting, right? Obviously in the 2D version, you can't see the rest of the hand, the other three knuckles, right? The back of the hand, these fingers. Nope, they're actually bent. There's the creases. We're gonna try to abstract it. That's a finger. Because I don't want that to be a big part of the image. See, I still want to give this impression of a hand, but not necessarily just the energy, right? This gesture that we're going for, which has dynamism. It's not about some photorealistic reproduction. There are incredible photographers in the world. There are many talented artists who can do that sort of stuff. It takes a lot of time, takes a lot of repetition. I'm keenly interested in whether things can be reduced to an essence and whether that essence can be captured. And if it can it be expressed in a way that others intuitively understand what's happening? There's the line, right? Hands coming down, this kind of disembodied hand. And like, that's almost it. Now, let's do it again, but do it in the style of the drawing that you see here, this reference image. So let's just look at that reference image. Take a look at that real closely. And let's do it again. Lock that first layer. Maybe even forget that we saw that. Well, can't forget that we saw it because our reference images, and you should check this out, it's an interesting feature. The reference images are bonded to the layer. So there. If I want that to be on the second layer so we can look at it, that reference image in the background there is going to disappear. So, whoop! That's gone. That's locked. We're going to say, we're going to call this firsthand. So it's drawn firsthand. And then we're going to move to the next version. So this one, let's see what Gravity Sketch does if we use the planar feature and bond this in two-dimensional space. Now this is easier to do a 3D print with because we should ideally, straight up, I think I could just trace this, right? Like, why not? Let's see what tracing looks like. You do it in VR. So we're going to lower our pen size. Make our pen itty bitty. Oh, well, it'll show up. What can we do here? Is this a thing? I'm curious. Is this going to work? So we're still in planar mode, right? Oh, and I'm drawing in the lock layer. Silly. Got to select that layer. And now, yeah, okay. But we want to put our actual drawing there, and now we can lower the opacity of this. And now theoretically, like straight up, just trace this guy here. Now see how little fidelity. Let's look at that side by side. If we look at that side by side, and look at my reference image, you can see it used some algorithmic, you know, simplification to smooth out my stroke. And I don't want that. So I'm going to go over here. I'm going to turn off all that smoothing. Speed, pressure, yeah, all that's good. Let's go to our preferences. We should see here, input smoothing. No, I don't want smoothing. I want super rough, crappy optical tracking. Let's see how that does by comparison. So we're still in layer 3. I'm going to grab our first stroke and get rid of that. Get rid of that. And then let's try again. And because we're in this virtual space, we don't have to be uncomfortable, right? Okay, two viewers. Hello, viewer. Whoever you are, wherever you are, I wish you well as a human being. I hope this brings you some joy or makes you feel some kind of way. So we're going to start here, and I'm literally just going to trace this and see what we end up with. And this is, of course, how I drew it with a pen. Original images. So, yeah, it was a lot easier to do with a pen, folks, I'll tell you that much. But I do like the line quality a lot more without the smoothing. So that's cool. And this planar feature means, and I don't know if you can see the detail here, but there's a red line that's coming from my controller and ending at our ground plane. So we have planar enabled, which means we're drawing a flat line, regardless of whether I move the touch controller vertically within the space along the Z-axis, we are still, along the Y-axis, we're still seeing the line flattened against the ground plane. Sweet. Yeah, we're going to speed this up a little bit because this will be boring just watching me trace. I mean, we could have just copy-pasted it, right? There's no reason why we wouldn't do something like this in Blender and just run a quick extrusion. For me, what's interesting is what happens when we take this 2D image and then start playing with it in three dimensions, potentially adding volumes and then seeing if we can, you know, through sheer force of will, turn it into a 3D model. Just put our brains to work and see if out of this line, which I think we've traced almost completely now. Did we miss this spot? Did we miss anything? Miss that? Little arrows. There we go. And a little loop. A little loop-de-loop there. Okay. So now, away from the reference image, I have made a mesh of strokes that fit there. Okay. Oh, yeah. Top of our pen cap. Gotta have that. And that, of course, has a little hidden signature by yours truly. Just in case, you know? Gotta leave a watermark in there. And if you guys end up making art for yourselves, you know, in the age of infinite digital reproduction, you can always hide something in there in case you gotta pull somebody's card when they said they did what you do. Like, do you really? So there is our image. And of course, in at least my first estimation, when I look at this, that one's really clear to me, and this is less so. Let's grab our 3D item, grab our mesh here, and we're going to group it. And what that does is it makes it a single selectable. And now, let's see what we can do to this, right? What? We see our collection of Bezier curves. We could turn it to a low poly model, which would work well for an AR implementation. Augmented reality, if we wanted to suspend this, put in a mobile gallery or something like that. We still got our planar enabled, and if we disable it, then we should be able to, like, pull this out. Whoa, right? What I'd like to do is extrude it along one dimension. Reset the thickness. Can we do that? Can we make this thicker? Ooh. So, but it's still, no, it's become three-dimensional. We leave our planar locked in. I didn't select it all. Look at that. I don't like it. I don't think it's going anywhere. So, let's undo that. And, of course, it didn't really undo it. Because some things aren't correctly implemented in the history. But maybe we can take that thickness and set it. So let's go back. Let's ungroup this. See if we can grab our weird. That was the line that got all messed up. And then let's reset that stroke thickness back to our original default. Okay, good. So now, but it just looks like a jumbled mess to some of you. But in front of me, I can kind of see our original sketch. Put it back here. There's a shadow. So I'm going to try to do it again with these abstracted volumes. So I'm going to grab a new layer. Okay. And now this one was, layer one. Call this layer one, second hand. I'm going to have these side by side to kind of compare the sketch. Okay. Nothing on layer three so far. So let's grab our volume tool. Where'd it go? It's a good thing we can just grab another one. There we go. There's our volume tool. And let's make ourselves a volume for the pen. And this first knuckle. Thumb and articulated. Flesh of the thumb moving into the meat palm. This isn't the thumb, excuse me, this is the pointer finger. Thumbs down here, knuckle. There you go. All right. Nice. I like the way that's turning out. It's a little flat though here. No lie, like my thumb's not that skinny. All right, there we go. That's better. So now we got this mass, this hand holding this stylus, right? And we can edit this stylus, right? We can make it crazy. We can make it like it's holding a drumstick. There. Bang that out. Okay, saved our move there. And now, hey, why don't you grab? Why don't you grab all the things? There we go. Let me kind of free our hand here. Look at that. It's a hand holding a hand. Now let's expand on this. Add the knuckles that you can't see in the 2D image, and potentially abandon our reference images altogether. Because now we're cruising. We kind of got this original gesture down. I like sculpting with volumes. It feels really organic. Just kind of putting play into motion. And the longer I do it, the more natural it feels. So first finger, second finger is actually, you know, depends on how you hold a pen. But I kind of hold a pen just with two fingers. And then this middle finger is actually bent sideways and gripping the underside. Do that, move that knuckle there, and then add some more volume to represent that phalange. And then there's the knuckle. Ish. Finger's kind of broken, hey fam? What's this volume doing here? What's that little guy? That guy doesn't need to be there. Get rid of that guy. Move this in. And there. And that's still, not really. Not really, folks. Nope. That one goes. Yeah. Still stylized. Still kind of what I was going for. But a little bit more realistic. Alright. I always holler in chat. Previous streams, we had some issues doing an overlay where I could actually visualize the chat and communicate with folks who were watching, and we had a couple crashes. Big shout out to Oculus. I mean, they spent billions to build this miraculous technology, but still working out the kinks, I'm sure. It's a lot of work. Cost billions. But here we are, truly, just benefactors of extraordinary technological innovation. And for myself, as somebody in the first world making this kind of art, it is a privilege. Truly a dubious luxury. So there's our hand. We got our thumb, middle finger, pointer finger. Let's get those two useless fingers. I always draw these like super quick when I gotta get rid of that. I don't know what that was. There, just kind of, there's those guys. Knuckle. Again, intentionally making it sloppy. because what I'm going for is the gestural quality of this. In the same way that if we were just throwing some clay, it's more about, does it feel real? But these are so smooth and this is so multifaceted. I almost want to try that one again. I don't want our character to end up, I don't want our hand to have sausage fingers. Now, one thing you will know if you've ever tried to draw and are just a practicing artist is that hands are often the most challenging thing. There's so much articulation going on in the human hand, and we are so familiar with them as objects by the time we become adults and watch Twitch streams, or even kids, whatever. So familiar with your hands that you can spot a fake, man. You can spot a lying hand. And so if you look, you'll see a lot of folks hide hands. Even painters, famous painters you see in museums, you know, the folks who show up in those art history classes, just hide the hands or spend a ton of time on the hands and just make them incredible. And in cartoons and very often just popular things, you will see hands just not really nothing. No hand, just a little lobster claw. Do I care about that? Did I care about that? No, I don't care. I don't want to make a hand and then a shoulder and then some disembodied nonsense. So we're almost there, folks, because I think this was just a simple, quick sketch. Like, let's get after it. Let's make it happen. Boom. I like it. But I think I want to make it bigger. And then we're going to be able to do some of the things that you can only do in VR. So, you know, when you draw something, you just, I often dream big, right? Big. And that would be awesome. And in my visual, my 2D work, I often play with scale where, like, you know, what if this was just insanely large, right? And this was a building, right? And you have like little balconies here or something. This hand doesn't lend itself well to a building, but if I were to 3D print this, right? And I wanted to make this like a miniature, like a real art piece, a sculpture, then I would want this hand, and this hand would have to sit on some kind of base, right? And that's where we might be able to take that two-dimensional part and put that back in. Ooh, wouldn't that be interesting? If we used this 2D part and we could grab all of it and let's see what happens. No. Dang. How do we? Because I want to edit all of it at once. But I dare say this guy isn't going to let me. Simplify it. Yeah, that's fine, but it doesn't really. I mean, that mesh is just too tight to be a base. But there, like, imagine if that was a printed, like, wireframe base and that was actually holding this guy up. Like, need some supports. Let me see, we got some little artifacts that got left over. Okay. All right. Well, what if... Again, you know, it's a lot of what ifs and a lot of talking to myself as a streamer with a small audience, but feel free to say hi in chat if you want. I'm just going to walk through it. So I'm going to lock this layer. I'm going to lock that layer for sure. And I'm going to lock our little drawing, but I'm going to make this other layer, which doesn't have anything in it right now. What's going on with this guy? What's going on here? What are you doing there? Oh, that's just the volume icon. Okay. Okay. We've got our layer here, and we're gonna make a base for this. That's a volume, but it's a volume that's loosely based on the shading that we were doing before. Almost make it like a landscape, right? That this massive sculpture is sitting over. And when we 3D print this, that's going to be the support. All right, there's our pen. Let's do that again. Nice. that articulation of the thumb. So like a super abstracted, angular, non-rounded version of the image that we have in 3D above, drop 3D below to sort of be like a base shadow on the ground. Now we can get rid of our little tracing thing. Where did that go? There, second hand, right. Begun, second hand. All right, now we've got this kind of cool dynamic brush stroke thing. What's going on there? All right, let's review what we've got so far. We've got this hand. Oh man, this knuckle isn't a finger. That fingerprint is not doing what I had hoped it would do, but that's okay. Let's go here. Let's find that one. And one of the things you can do is you can have different colors for your layers, right? Especially since when we print this, the goal is not to texture map it and get into all that. So something I may start doing is using a slightly different color, but it's so visually problematic for me. I don't like doing it. So I'll make this a little more delicate, a little smaller, and then add another volume. Represent that finger. And that means that we gotta move this, and then this, and then this in series. Okay. Cool. Cool. Not in a photorealism contest. In many ways, it reminds me of the rock creature from Galaxy Quest. Shout out to Galaxy Quest. But I like it. And this hand is almost, yeah. Good. All right, good and awesome. So now we've got our hand in place. This finger very much, very, very elephant man. That's all right. This joint, we do wanna, yep. And then what can we do that's interesting here inside this palm? And we've kind of expressed this like really dynamic energy coming from here. Yeah, but this is sloppy. That's not gonna cut it. So let's get rid of that. Although it had the spirit of what we wanted to do, that volume is no longer gonna be sufficient. We're gonna need some more articulation. We're gonna have to draw every part of it because we're in three dimensions. Gonna add that as well. It's not ludicrously thin. That, on the other hand, just doesn't look very convincing as a volume. So I have to consciously slow this down, and I'm moving my hand almost in this spiral shape as I fill that volume and hopefully got it in three dimensions. Nice. Now this, just do that same thing here again. All right. And then this last little fella, we're gonna make our selection. We're just gonna make it smaller. Yeah. And now let's do that same thing to this elementary volume here. A cool hand, but now when we look in there, we see more of like, because I want this to sit on somebody's tabletop, right? I want you to be able to buy this figurine and have it sit on your desk and have it be this, you know, conversation piece, if you will. So then what can make this interesting? And to me, what makes things interesting is a bunch of wires and gears and cool electromech crap. So that is what we're going to add next. So let's lock our layer. Let's remember to save. Floppy disks remind us to save. So we're gonna call this first hand we've done here on the stream. May come back to that at some point. and let's give ourselves a new layer. Is our first hand layer matter anymore? No. This was our original reference image. I'll keep this around. Unlock some of these guys. This is our first hand. Okay, let's have that up for comparison. There it is. And that was just a quick single stroke, couple stroke abstraction. Right, and you can kind of see it. Here, we'll rotate it so you can see the side. And here we have like our third hand. Let's look at second hand. Second hand was our little shadow. Don't need that. First hand, don't need that. Lock them, lock them. And then let me grab a drink. Back to it. And we got a hard stop here in an hour because it is Friday night and I know you all have places to be. So let's do this. That's our layer three. That's actually our standing hand. Stand hand. And I don't think there's anything on this layer. Layer one. Nothing doing. Nothing doing over there. There's another reference sketch for us. Put that in the background, maybe. Loom and large and in charge. But now blocking my chat window. All right. And then let's get into some details on this hand model. Maybe a hand model. My favorite Joe Pesci. Cool. And then let's go down here. Layer one. I want to say that one's useless. And all right, now we're all set up to put some details on this and start playing with that perspective. That awesome shift in perspective that can only happen in VR, where suddenly this hand is larger than life and back to handheld scale. Now we're going to name this layer. I'm going to name it scaffold. Scaffolding, because I like that. That's what we're going to do. So let's get ourselves some little scaffolding. And now we got to be conscious, if we're going to 3D print this, of the hollows and the difficulty that we'll have with a lot of voids and complicated shapes. So let's say we just put together a really quick ladder, right? We said, okay, here's like a ladder scaffolding piece. We're just gonna narrow it down, make it real skinny. Cool, perfect. That's one part of our ladder, right? I want to duplicate it. All right, now I got two. And now let's put some rungs in. So let's grab that. Now we take this one. And we shrink it down. Itty bitty fork and spoon. A little bit thicker than that, or else we're gonna stand on it. There we go. Now I didn't make them vertical because I didn't make them flat like steps like we made in our airboat the other night. Because I want them to be small and I want to be able to put them at all sorts of angles and still have them make sense. Alright. So let's lock that in. Yeah, all right. And then we're going to just... put that together. And there's a little ladder. Called Jacob's Ladder. Group it. Shrink it. Then we can start, like, putting these ladders places, right? I mean, you just want to climb up there. And once they get up there, they're going to want to move a little bit further up this pen. This can't hang. It's just got to, kind of got to be printed onto the pen. I Now that begs the question of a little platform for our scaffold, right? We're gonna wanna be able to put some platforms in. So let's get ourselves a quick planar platform. So we're gonna use a soft cube, round it a little bit, make it nice and small. Perfect, little platform. Or a minifig to stand on if we're gonna do that. Cool, yeah, and I don't mind it myself. Let's make a copy of our platform. Then we got original ladder, original platform, in case we want to reuse those, right? The sort of prefab shapes that we've just got handy lying around. I think I also want like a double ladder. So to build my double ladder, just real quick, or take this, break it apart, edit it again, extend it, and this way we're just, our geometry is just going to be a little bit better this way, I think. Delete that guy, copy that guy, keep him parallel if we can.
I don't believe in this notion of some sort of secret societies controlling people, but of course, in any political system, there are sort of over the table and under the table arrangements.
Alright, now take apart our big rungs and go like that. Place that down here. Alright, now we got this super long ladder if we need it. It's a little bit sloppy, but like, come on, man. This is a free Twitch stream. And then gonna scale it again. Money. And the other cool thing is that we can always make it. We can always zoom in, if you will, which is just expanding our hands, right? Like pinching and pulling it apart so that we have more fine motor control over particular objects. Okay, I am happy with that ladder. I could climb that ladder right now if I wanted to, let it fall down. And that would be an awesome fail. You know, I had a friend tell me the other day, like, hey, if you really want some users, you just need to fall down on your stream. Then you'll have a live stream fail. And I thought to myself, man, it's really hard to get ahead in show business. It's like, well, you got famous for a blooper reel. All right. Small ladder, big ladder, platform, check. Back to it. Copy a little scaffold there, because that will look, oh, because that'll look cool. I think. Yeah, that'll look cooler over here. And something I just realized is that our balance, right, when we look at it from here, it's kind of like leaning. And I don't mind that, but I feel like it would be cooler when you actually hold a pen too, if this thumb came around a little bit. So we'll come back to that in a bit. Actually, we'll have to come back to that if we're gonna put scaffolding up. We wanna make a decision around that stat. So here's our stand hand. Let's select that. Let's lock the layers we don't wanna accidentally mess with. Let's bring this thumb out to this side. Like more action there. And then this is, there we go, on the meat of the hand, flexing. Okay, I like that more. Yes, yes, more dynamic. Hand is still action-packed. It still looks like it's moving. It's about to move that pen across the canvas. All right, let's lock that up, go back to our scaffolding. Let's just separate these out. We got tons of space. We got infinite virtual space, right? be able to grab those pretty easily. All right, let's put that little scaffold there. Head on up to the thumb. Climb on up here. Get over the scaffold. Let's take this scaffold real quick and stretch it. Not that much, but just like double so the person can get across. Check. There you go. Now, by the way, those of you interested in like level design and stuff like that, like you can see how this tool would be really valuable for quickly mocking up like a platformer. Because I think, you know, indie games are so awesome these days. Like, I've seen just so many great indie titles. But I'm kind of a sucker for good graphics. And I feel like the challenge that a lot of those pixel art folks have is, you know, coming up with, like, better environments. And everybody wants to make cyberpunk, without the bugs, of course. But it's incredibly time-consuming to develop all those assets. So maybe this is a quick prototyping alternative that you could do if you wanted to generate 3D assets for your Infinity, you know, Unity game or whatever. I mean, Kermit T. Put a ladder there for my scaffolding, because I think that's neat. Put another one there. Okay, what other elements could we put on? Scaffolding is looking pretty neat. I like that angle coming back. And then dragging that out. There. Yes. 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 Alright, we figured out a way to get to the top of our hand. Once we're up top, I want to get back down here. Put a little cubby here. I'm feeling this is going to be my favorite spot right there. Just kind of hanging out. Yep. And then, what else? What else can we do? We're grabbing this guy here. Platform, straighten it out a little bit. Around. That's fresh. This is my alien bass music playlist. I'm a big fan. I'm not the Martian ambassador, but if like the Martian ambassador came through and played a sick dub, like I'd be all right with that. And of course, it's not the kind of music you can listen to just like anytime. But it is good flow state side soundtrack for us. Ideally, also doesn't clash too much with copyright rules, although I don't expect too many people to catch this later. In fact, large part, the stream is, like most of Dubious Luxury, an experiment for me. Check, check, check. I feel like we've done some things with the scaffolding there. This ongoing theme of like home is where the art is. So let's see what we can do about that. Let's go back to our stand hand. Let's give it a little more volume. Simplify some of these surfaces. Wrist. I want to avoid having too many hollows and overhangs. Like it's still interesting, but it's not so hollow. Okay, yes, 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 and yes. And then at the top of our hand, don't want to build a house because it's so obvious. But I do, but I don't. I don't want to start on a whole house right now, people. Houses take a long time to build if you ever built a house. It's like everybody thinks it's easy. But it's not. What we do have going for us is that there is no building code, no rules, because it's art. We can do whatever we want when we paint. You know, sometimes at work, folks reference Bob Ross. And Bob Ross popularized landscape painting for so many people, but so often non-artists think that Bob Ross is art. And I just want to remind you that, like, you know, when you were five and you just scribbled some crazy stuff, that was art too. And all it is being creative for the sake of being creative, make something. And the experience of just making something is, in my opinion, one of the most redeeming qualities of our species. But it has intrinsic value in and of itself, regardless of whether it's a commodity or something that you can sell or market, profit off of, or whatever. Because we're, in many ways, conditioned to consume these days. And if it's not making money, then why are you doing it? So I will tell you, we have the dubious luxury of making whatever we want. We're very lucky to have that opportunity. So, I'm trying to take advantage of that here on the stream with you tonight. Without getting too deep. But hey, there's two people. Nobody's going to watch. It's all good. So I'm not going to put a house up here. I do want some more scaffolding or something to be at the top of this hand. And I don't want it to be another hand because that would be ridiculous. So let's just add some more scaffolding and then just say, like, hey, that was actually pretty great. Let's grab our stuff here. Let's move it over to this side. Maybe inspiration will strike us as we continue adding pieces to this. You know what? We're going to add you, the viewers. We're going to put in some figures that are on this hand, maybe working on it, or something like that, with us. Maybe not. I don't know. Just thinking out loud here. Put another ladder here. I like this hand as well. Give it that cool. This is the one that's going to drive my printer nuts. Nobody wants to deal with that. It's gonna like melt. Super overhang. Does it add to the image? Does that ladder add anything? No. That ladder does not add anything. What if we place the ladder like this? In this like counter angle? See how that like offsets this energy that's coming up into the left. And sometimes you want to do that contrast and that looks awesome, but I don't think so in this case. Furthermore, I'd say we got a good thing going with this gangsterly in this finger head. And I don't like how it got broken into something straight and very normal there. So I'm gonna go like that. To preserve that dynamism that we had in our original. Better. Whoopie, 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 whoopie. That would be so silly sometimes. Let's switch this up. All right, that looks great. Love it. All right. Let's listen to something a little bit different, maybe. Heyo, Friday night. Let's go, Twitch. All right, epic. Shoots and ladders here. Oh. Oh. I left my tools over there? Jeez. Okay. All right. All right, viewers. Go. Put that mess up there. Put that there. Put that there. I told you that was going to be my favorite part. I could climb up. I could climb up. Oh, but if I was a little kid and I wanted to get over there, I'd want a little ladder, like super dangerous, sketchy ladder, like there to there, right? Like, man, if we were at the burn, totally build this. So there we go. Just needed a way of getting from there to there. Now, this is what's really incredible about virtual reality in general is that, like, I could just grab this thing and make it life size for myself standing in here inside this hand. Whoop, 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 whoop. I mean, that's not it. Cut that, but. Alright. Alright. Nope. Blew it. Nope. Get that back. Yeah, I feel like that, we could just run with that. I feel like that's like, desk good enough. We just straighten out our foundation. I feel like, you know, like everybody wants there to be, I want there to be something really interesting up here on this top. But I feel like maybe the piece is best appreciated. If I 3D printed this, that small. Yeah, you kind of gotta. I would want to put something over here. You will not be able to stay home, brother. You will not be able to plug in, turn on, and cop out. You will not be able to lose yourself on Skag and skip out for beer during commercials because the revolution will not be televised. Mm-hmm. The revolution will not be televised. Revolution will not be brought to you by Xerox in four parts without commercial interruptions. Look too intentional now. Let's get him out of there. And now I guess we want to, maybe we take our scaffolding scrap pile and move them all to a different layer. So we're just going to call this utility. And that's our utility layer. Just put everything in it. And now we can just hide it. And this last bucket can go there too. All right, we sort of cleaned up our workspace. Got this cool looking hand, some final adjustments on flatness, right? Like that's off. Make that level with the ground as much as we can. It's floating in free space, which it should not do. Our ladders are connected. That ladder needs to be just a little bit wider. All right. Does that ladder enhance or detract from our scene? This platform isn't. The platform's cool, but. Yeah, that finger isn't really holding. This point, this intersection right here is so important. Let's go to our stand hand, take that, put that in. There we go. Okay. So we're 1 hour and 2 minutes in, and we have made, from our original reference sketch, boom. Viewer, welcome, whoever you are. I wish you well. I hope you're doing good. Welcome to the stream. This is Dubious Luxury. My name's Dublux. I am your host, and what we've been doing here is working off of some of my old 2D sketches. We have this simple abstraction of a hand drawing, and we've worked through a number of different iterations to get to this, which is the hand sculpted into 3D with our scaffolding here, looking like a virtual construction site, ideally compatible with the 3D print. Of course, we're going to want to use... Let's go back to our hand. We're gonna make a volume right there. Ideally compatible with a resin printer, because I do not expect a filament to be able to handle this. And there may be some more finishing required, finishing and polishing of these models, which we will learn together on finishing and polishing day, which is generally, I want to say, Tuesdays on the stream and their schedule. We do finishing and polishing of these models, preparing them for 3D printing. But most of the time, and this is the fun part, we're doing prototyping and engaging in new original artwork. So this is kind of cool because it's evocative of some kind of bony get down. Let's grab that and bring it in. All right. There we go. And there's our side by side. Let's take a selfie. Hey. And maybe a little square one. You know, for the gram. Work in progress. And then, you know, because this is really cool, one of these detail shots. Okay, now I'm at the back of my space. You see, I'm about to walk into something. All right, cool. So there's our hand. I don't know, what do you guys think? Maybe a pen cap? Something a little bit. Let's put a pen cap on there just so that pen looks a little more legit. And then we will stop the stream for the night. I know you just arrived, whoever you are, viewer number 3. Say hi, subscribe. I do have a regular schedule. So we do this pretty often. What gives? Should be a... All right, still got the camera open. All right, there. There we go. And take this. This is going to be our little, like, pen cap. Spin it just a little bit. Cool. Cool. And then, I really want to do something with this hand, with this finger. Like, that's so not my fingertip. So, we're going to take a risk here, folks. And we're going to work on this, which is the Bezier curves. Sorry, the vertex points that make up this mesh. Okay. There we go. Maybe bring that out a little bit. And then bring that up and in. All right. Yeah. Hand's got that cool gangster lean. It's definitely like hanging there in space. Got this little construction site, you know, little finishing details. This part's like hanging in midair. I wonder whether supports, you know, would look better on our scaffold, but it's intersecting well. Do we miss any glaring geometry in here? Yes, we're going to need. In the second hand, in the stand hand, we're going to need a volume right through here. Boom. All right. See, now we're filling that in. There it is. All right. Yeah. Except this part right here. So nobody's hand is... Fill that in. Give that a nice natural crease. Just get up in there. All right. All right, my trees look like happy trees. Now, what I think we really missed an opportunity down here in the bottom to make, to add some more visual meaning, right? I mean, this is really just noise down here. And we originally started it by redrawing this. And so let's go back to that energy. And let's redo this bottom. And then I promise to stop. So where is our layer 2, aka bottom? Boom. That was not hard to make. We can always make it again. All right. And then I'm assuming this was part of second hand by accident. Stand hand. Okay. So let's work on our ground here. In the shadow of our giant hand. So we've got our volumes. Let's use a square stroke. And then again, we're going to enable this planar function, which is going to lock this flat to the ground. Loving it. Okay. So let's go here. Let's go here. And then let's redo sort of the image that we have here, our original reference image. So... get a little bit smaller. Make this almost like a step. All right. And notice this is filling it in because we're not using a stroke, we're using volume. And so I'm going to use stroke instead and try and achieve this same, but see that this stroke is now like rotating all over the place. I don't want it to do that. So can we fix that? Can't we make it cleaner and then just make it stick? Yeah. There we go. All right. So now let's grab our little reference image. And let's draw it again. Or, and this would be like really fun, see that shadow above it? See that shadow above it? Well, gosh, if only we could move that light around. Can we move that light around? I think we can. So let's go and change our lighting. So we go to our preferences here, our work scene, and sure enough, there is our light. And you can see as I move it, we actually get closer and closer to our reference image. In terms of the shadow, it's projected there. There's that shadow. Cool. That's what I wanted. Single piece, a path. Elaborate on it a little bit more, get some more character. That's the pen. There's their thumb. Articulate it around. Coming in here. And then, there's the line coming out the back. Now, is that going to balance? I mean, most of the weight here, if we were to print this out, do you think that would balance? Let's turn it a little bit so it would. And let's grab that. Because most of the weight, that would flip over. Yeah, that's the right concept, just poor execution. So let's do it again. There's our pen, top knuckle, the hand itself, the thumb, and the pen. Nope, doesn't look better. I don't like it. Let's go back in time. There. That's actually really, really close. All right. Switch this up real quick. It's getting a little too soulful for our anonymous audience. All right, there we go. Yes, and yes, 100%. Yep, I think that's doing it. Gotta get rid of that. All right, check and check. So we've got this big hand, and we have effectively given it a base. Ideally, a base that's going to print pretty well in 3D. Again, especially if we're printing it as two different pieces. Or if we're just using resin. We'll just have some supports in there that will knock out. Oh no. Oh no. Always something. This right here, but I promised to stop, so we're just gonna have to be satisfied with what we've got. Nope. around non-planar volume. Volume, non-planar, round. It's the pinky finger, right? Pointer finger there, middle finger, ring finger, and then just a little pinky. Locked in. Even more articulation there. Throw that knuckle in. Oh, and you grab a bucket. Put a bucket over there. Ready to spill over. There it is. Sick. Flat? Yeah, it's flat enough. Almost begs for another line down there. Let's go back to our stroke, square, line it up, make sure it's planar, and make sure we're in our bottom. Well, at this point I think we are. Let's make sure we're in our bottom layer. Bottom. Lock this up, and there's our pen, and then this is just going to be like that. There. Yeah, I could do that. I mean, I could do that for another hour, folks. So, there it is. There's our hand. I'm going to save it as hand final. Chat with you for a second. And then we'll call it good. And one last... Oh, and then of course, yeah. Certainly addictive. I just want to do it all the time. Cut that music out and say thank you all very much wherever you were, however you viewed the stream. Be well, be creative, and we'll see you again. Have a great weekend. Safe Martin Luther King Day if you're in the States, and if you're somewhere else in the world, I apologize on behalf of the United States. All right. Good night.